one, the name is Me Little Crazy, but you can call me Crazy. Now, we're back at this again. Me in my bed, because it's really comfortable to watch anime in. And just watch anime. Now, today's episode has been a difficult one. Why? Because I technically never saw the series. I only saw one episode, then that's it. Now, given the fact that I only saw one episode and I know very little of it, I acquired a friend by the name. What's your name? Hello?
Oh my god, the cringe, man. It's clearly Sino Ghost. Come on. You should know me already.
Sino Ghost.
Come on. The fails.
I have no idea how to spell it because apparently I forgot.
X-E-N-O-G-H-O-S-T.
Whatever.
Come on, man.
His icon's gonna be right in the corner somewhere. Depending on whatever. It's gonna be there.
Yeah.
Somewhere. Now, Mr. Expert of High School AXD, who watched a year
yes.
ago. How does the first episode go?
Well, it starts off with a perverted ass fuck, Issa Hyoto, and his two friends, right? And what ends up happening is that this girl comes up to him and asks him out on a date, like any regular shit. What ends up happening later on in the episode is that, yay, they're having a wonderful and fun date until she turns out to be a fallen angel and kills his ass. Luckily, this bastard had a fucking pamphlet with him of the demons, so the only person he could think of at that moment was, for some reason, Rhea's Grimory, for he had seen her previously in the first 5 minutes of the episode.
And you might be wondering why he thought of her specifically. It's because plot.
No, for some reason, red hair came to mind. Crimson red hair came to mind, and because of the blood, when he was literally spilling blood everywhere, gore everywhere, like all he could think of was red. So the first thing he ever thought of was Rhea's Grimory because of her red hair, her crimson hair. So as because of that, she magically appeared and saved his life. But the best way possible, man, because the only way she could heal him is if they're both naked. Oh, yeah. And then that sets off for episode 2. Oh, yeah, that's so far how it starts off.
Pretty much.
Yeah. That's basically how it starts off.
But
then you later find. Huh?
I was gonna ask you, what is the main thing that's gonna happen throughout the entire series, but you can continue.
Well, what ends up happening eventually is that you find out why they wanted to kill him. They wanted to kill him because he had something unique, which was every so often the Red Dragon Emperor and the White Dragon Emperor, I believe, are reborn inside a human.
Reborn.
Luckily, Issei had that. He was like partly reincarnation of the Red Dragon Emperor, so therefore he's special. And because of the fallen angels found him as a threat, so they sent someone to kill him. So forth, Rias ends up making him one of his pawns, using all 9 of her pawns. For some reason, this anime has the demons base their ranking and everything by, like, a chessboard. Forget which one. Where there's a king, queen, and everything.
Chess.
My god, why was I thinking of checkers? So forth, right? And throughout the first season, he ends up meeting all the characters, like the king, Rhea's Grimory, Akino, who's the queen, Yuto, who's one of the knights, and Koneko, who is the rook. Yeah. But afterwards, an episode, like, let's say it was around episode 4, I'm not exactly sure, he meets Asia Argento, which ends up being one of the main important things that ends up coming up in season 3. Our Asya, she's working with the Fallen Angels without actually knowing it. Once she finds out, they were going to use her as a sacrifice because of her healing factor. But luckily, Issei managed to rescue her. Managed to rescue her, right? So what ends up occurring is that Rias...
Okay, you don't have to go any further because of spoilers and stuff like that. Even though it's like years old. Anyway. Yes. That's basically the main premise. Or first few premises. Then moves on to season 2, which is another storyline. We'll get to that another time. So anyway. Just by hearing all that, I scale from 1 out of 10, I would say an 8. Why an 8? Because, it can extremely be easily mistaken for one of those super fan service animes. Where, it just shows plot and no actual story. Because of the way it looks. Which is stupid. Because if we actually get into it, it's way more than just plot.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
What do you rate it? Out of 1 out of 10.
11.
11.
For sure. For sure, an 11. It's one of my favorite enemies of all time.
Makes sense. Considering you are the harem god.
Yeah.
Basically, that's it. Well, this is the... Damn it, I forgot his name. This is... I keep thinking Exo-Ghost, but it's not Exo-Ghost. It's Xeno-Ghost.
Yeah, come on, man. I've been in YouTube for like a month now. Seriously, everyone should know my name. Longest outro ever.
But anyway, guys, that's basically the end of the video. You like it? Like it. If you didn't like it, like it still and leave a comment what I did wrong. And what
which
I
did
wrong.
Which is a lot.
Yeah, a lot. Actually, this is actually the first time I've actually ever done something with another person on anime-related topics. Actually, no, this is the second collab I've ever done. The first collab was with... Ugh. Never mind. Yeah! Comments, subscribe, all that jazz.
That guy with
and
the
as always, guy with the tie. Yeah, him. Okay. Anyway. Happy New Year! And all that jazz. So keep smiling and I'll see you in the next story. Hasta luego! Going back to sleep. So if you want like a part 2 type thing, go to Xeno-Ghost's channel, because he's gonna probably do a way better job of explaining everything and probably some spoilers stuff, so check us out, check out our channel, please.